In this section, we will talk about how to perform supraliminal tests with Inventis Piano. Exams conducted above the hearing threshold allow audiologists to identify the level of hearing damage in better detail and to differentiate between cochlear and retrocochlear disorders. In this video, we will have a look at how simple it is to carry out these tests, focusing on the 10 test, the SISI test, and the Stenger test. The 10 test can be used to detect a dead region in the cochlea. The test involves measuring the threshold for detecting a pure tone presented within a background noise, called threshold equalizing noise. It is necessary to assess the patient's pure tone threshold beforehand, which is then displayed in the background of the graph. While executing the exam, the background noise must be added to each frequency of the pure tone signal, at least 10 decibels above the hearing threshold. Both the tone and the background noise are played in the same ear of the patient. If the resulting masked threshold is 10 decibels or more above that of both the threshold and the 10 noise, the cochlea is considered dead at that frequency. The short increment sensitivity index test, also known as SISI, assesses the ear's ability to identify brief variations of intensity within a continuous pure tone. To perform the SISI test, the operator must first bring up the relative window from the main menu. The test is an automatic procedure, and it is conducted by presenting a tone at different frequencies with an intensity 20 decibels above the hearing threshold. When starting the exam, a sequence of 20 increments in intensity will be presented to the patient and their responses will be counted. The amplitude of the increments can be set to either 1 decibel or 5 decibels. Increments of 1 decibel should be imperceptible, or in the event that the percentage of the perceived increments is higher than 30%, it could be an indication of a cochlear disorder. The Stenger test can be used to establish whether a measured hearing threshold is genuine. It is based on the Stenger effect, which states that if a single frequency sound is presented simultaneously to both ears of an individual, each at different intensities, it will be heard only by the ear exposed to the higher intensity. To perform the Stenger test, the operator must first bring up the relative window from the main menu. Having established the hearing threshold for a given frequency, the tone is presented to the good ear, 5 to 10 decibels higher than the hearing threshold, and presented to the bad ear at a level slightly lower than the supposed threshold. If there is a genuine loss of hearing in the bad ear, the patient will indicate that the sound can be heard in the good ear. A different response means that the hearing loss is not genuine.